I've seen news reporting after news reporting, tweet after tweet saying, quote, unidentified, masked stormtroopers. Again, I want to foot stomp on the secretary said. It is offensive to refer to these dedicated men and women that are out there as law enforcement professionals to make that reference. It is disgusting. And it's also a lie. As we can see, we've shown you time and time again. So you saw the markings that Deputy Director Klein put out. I wanted to blow that up to show you. Our BORTAC agents, for example, this is the identification every single one of them has on their uniform. And this is a baseline. This is a baseline. I wanted to bring a real live version. This is what they're wearing. This is a real live version of what they're wearing. And this is a baseline of all the different identifications that they have. So first and foremost, you see clearly marked that they are part of the Customs and Border Protection. The second line of marking is it shows a component within CBP that they're associated with. And this instant, Border Patrol. Clearly police. It's marked on the front and the back, clearly, every single agent. In addition to that, they have a unique identifier. Director Klein said he doesn't have his officers wear name tags because they're being doxxed. That's exactly right. That's another thing that's absolutely disgusting. So they're not only jeopardizing the lives of the agents, but they're also jeopardizing the lives of their families as they're putting out their home information and they're suggesting that individuals go to their homes. So yes, I, as the acting commissioner, have authorized and supported removing their names from their uniform. Instead, what we have, though, is a personal identifier. So we have that, so we can identify, and we have each identifier associated with a specific name, so we have all that information internally. And we'll share that with the appropriate entities when it's necessary. Our SRT teams, it's the same thing, right? Clearly identified. Different color uniform, clearly identified. So I hope that puts to rest the lies and the false rumors about that they're not properly marked. The last thing that I'll mention about this as well is there's been some additional information out there about how they identify themselves. You will find in each and every instance when we approach somebody who we believe, who we have probable cause, who has committed a federal crime, we do identify ourselves as either police or a federal agent. That's the truth. They come there each and every night. They, with intent, arm themselves with a barrage of weapons with the intent to destroy federal property and seriously injure federal law enforcement officers. Those are the individuals that we're talking about. So when you see a CBP BORTAC agent or a SRT officer that is out there, they are doing so in that very targeted fashion to go after somebody that has committed a federal crime. And that very narrow target approach, what I'm talking about specifically, are those who have actually intentionally harmed a federal officer. So, and they're doing so while these agents and officers are protecting the federal property. So we are, in that case, we will make a targeted arrest based on probable cause. And that includes, as the secretary said, even if that subject goes off the property. It just makes common sense. We're not going to allow somebody to walk up to the federal property, assault a federal officer or agent, and because then they walk off federal property, then we're going to say, oh, we can't go arrest you. Well, that doesn't make sense. Of course we're going to arrest you, and we have the authority to make that arrest, and we will continue to do that. So what this means is we're not patrolling the streets of Portland has been falsely reported multiple times in the past few days. I'd like to address two other persistent questions that come up. First, unmarked vehicles. Look, I've been in law enforcement for almost 3 decades. The use of unmarked vehicles is a standard procedure, a standard practice among every local, state, and federal law enforcement agency in this country, actually in the world. It's nothing new. But it's especially important under these circumstances. Every one of us known, every one of us in the past few weeks has seen, what have they been doing? I call these individuals criminals, not the peaceful protesters, but the individuals, again, with intent that are going to go out and actually target marked vehicles. We've seen it time and time again. We've seen marked patrol vehicles in the last few weeks among a variety of cities through this country on fire.
We all know about the story in New York where an incendiary device was actually thrown inside a marked vehicle while there were uniformed officers inside the vehicle. So, yeah, I think not only is it a common practice among law enforcement, but also in these circumstances, it makes sense to use an unmarked vehicle, not only first and foremost for the protection of the officers and agents doing their job to protect federal property and arresting criminals, but also for the protection of the public.